Hi YouTube, just a quickie garden update. We're starting to get the whole beans climbing up the teepee. It's funny, I thought this side was going to be not as vigorous as the other side because it would be more in the shade, and it's doing much better than the other side. So figure that one out. But they are finding the strings, and they're following them right up as planned. Hopefully before the end of summer, they'll cover it. We'll see. And oh, here's the potatoes. I've extended, the bins are, the two I started late, they're all the way out. I'm still going to be covering them up with some straw. This one's not doing as well as that one, but oh well. And the older potatoes, I've got flowers on them. So that's cool. And my leaf lettuce, of course, is going to seed. And this isn't so bad. Oh, look at that weed right in the middle. The mesculin is still pretty good. And the butter crunch, but the arugula, it's pretty much gone. And whether I ever get flowers that you can eat, I don't know, but they're still doing their thing in the middle. I have a confession to make. I did not get my little cherry tomatoes in the garden before they got really dry. I feel really guilty. They're coming back. This one especially is pretty pathetic. But that's what I did. I didn't get them in the ground. So here's my big confession on YouTube. And then the other tomatoes, I finally got caged. And whether I get carrots around them or not, this year was kind of hard because I didn't have the garden finished. So I couldn't plant the early stuff and before the bigger plants that will take over the square. I had to plant it all at once. And like I would have planted the carrots earlier and then set the tomatoes out so that they would have, the carrots would have been mature before the tomatoes got this big. So next year will be better. I can time things better. But the tomatoes are doing really well and have some blossoms going on. These are Romas, heirloom Roma type of tomato. And all the spinach, we harvested all the spinach. I have some going in the dehydrator right now. And I'm going to be putting some beans in here, I think. And finally, the squash with the hot weather we've had. The squash is taking off, and I'm training it up the trellis. That's working out quite well. This is the butternut squash. And next door are my cantaloupes, and they have blossoms already. I was kind of surprised. I don't know if you can see that one peeking out right there, but you can see them from the other side. And I think that's going to be nice, being able to harvest from both sides of that trellis. And my little sugar baby watermelons that I started from seed, I lost one out of the four, but that was okay. They're doing very well, and they're starting to go up. And then this is totally out of control. This has reached the top of the trellis already. This is my acorn squash. I've never grown acorn squash before. I did not realize it was this huge. There are three plants there. And we'll see where I can go with it. But it's already got blossoms too. Right under there, which surprised me. I thought it was kind of early. You can see I've got some spinach going to seed amidst my broccoli and cauliflower. Maybe I'll try to save some seeds. I've never done that. And I've been harvesting quite a bit of broccoli. Got some in the fridge. My heads didn't get as big as I'd like, but at least it didn't bolt on me, so I was kind of afraid about that. So it's doing well. The beans, beans are doing okay. I think we're going to have a good bean crop, but I'm still getting those weird leaves, like, I don't know. I'm getting flowers. They're going to do their thing. But I've never had the leaves do this. So I thought it was because they're getting too much water, which it very well may be. But I'm also suspicious that maybe the layers were not composted down enough for beans, because I think beans are kind of sensitive to that. So maybe next year we'll tell the tale. If I get it next year, I'll say it's water or whatever, and if it doesn't do it, then I'll kind of know maybe it was maybe the compost. And the odd thing happened. I have a tomato maybe two tomatoes, coming up in the strawberries. No clue how they got there. Didn't plant them, but they came up. You can see right there. So I'll have to see what kind of tomato plant that is. And I got the radishes away from my peppers, and so they're doing much better. You can see I've got peppers coming. One there. Those are the red peppers. These have little blossoms and little baby peppers coming. These are the yellows. And then the greens, the green peppers. That looks suspiciously like it's going to be a hot pepper, but I don't like hot peppers, so hopefully not. These are supposed to be the green peppers. Swiss chard, going to town. I don't know too much about Swiss chard, to be honest. I've never planted it before, so I don't know. Can we still eat it this big? I'm going to try. Or does it get bitter? Well, we'll find out. But that's an update on the garden. Still no heads of cauliflower that I can see starting. Maybe they're down in there. Don't know. Big plants. No heads of cauliflower, except for that odd little one that went crazy early on. I don't remember them taking this long. I haven't grown them for a few years, though, so maybe I just don't remember. But that's an update. It's really a beautiful day. We've got weather in the 60s and low 70s today. We've had 80 degree weather last week. Well, actually in the 90s. Definitely not a hot weather girl. So I just have to show you my lavender. I love. Oh, and my embarrassment, south side of the house that's full of weeds that I don't know what to do with. But this lavender is just gorgeous. I'm thinking cold frames because this is the south side and it'll stay warm. But right now it's a weed bed. Okay, YouTube. Signing off. Bye-bye.